apologize for moderating my service, and I did it again at the Standard Green Air on 10:40 a.m. in the Bahamas, and 104.5 FM. Again, I want to thank all of our listeners for listening in this morning, and as well all of our members who are in service here today. This morning, my task here is very easy one, and one that I take very seriously, to proclaim with us that the Lord at any time when an opportunity arises. But this morning we are coming live on radio, and for the next few minutes we're going to encourage you, let you know that God is still on his throne. Amen. Amen. I want you to get your Bibles, if you have your Bibles, and I want you to go with me to Luke chapter 7. I want to look at Luke chapter 7, and I want to go to Matthew chapter 2. Luke chapter 7 says, and when he had ended all his saying in the audience of the people, he entered into Capernaum, and a certain centurion servant who was there under him was sick and ready to die. And when he heard of Jesus, he sent unto him the elders of the Jews, beseeching him that he would come and heal his servants. Let's go to verse 9. Then Jesus heard these things, he marveled at him, and turned him about, and said unto him, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. Amen. Matthew chapter 2 finds us talking about when Herod had instructed the wise men to go and to bring words back concerning Jesus Christ, that he too must come and worship him. And 2:17 we find, then was fulfilled the prophecy which was spoken by Jeremiah, the prophet, saying, in Ramah was there a voice heard, lamenting and weeping and great mourning, Rachel weeping for her children, and would not be comforted. This morning I want to look at four greats: the great mourning, the great faith, the great earthquake, and the great commission. Amen. The great mourning, the great faith, the great earthquake, and the great commission. Again, good morning to all of you in Radio Land. And you, my faithful members of the Word of Faith family. Yes. We once again witnesses on this beautiful morning to an act or event that took place over 2,000 years ago. In which Jesus Christ, the matchless Son of God, was crucified, died, and rose again. He was a man noted for his good works and his miraculous deeds. He was placed in a tomb, and on the third day, he rose from the dead. Yes. My friends, today, Jesus is both not only a man, but he was both God and man. Yes. And was the only candidate qualified to redeem man from Satan's bondage and to restore him to his rightful position as joint heirs in the kingdom of God. The Bible tells us that God prepared a body for Jesus in Hebrews chapter 10:5. And theologian says he traveled through 40 generations. He robed himself in flesh to become the ultimate sacrifice for the sins of the world. But may I tell you this morning that upon his arrival, Satan had a guard of honor comprising demons waiting for him. Yeah. When Gabriel appeared to Mary and told her that she would be the mother of Jesus and that the Holy Ghost will overshadow her and she would conceive, the demonic guard of honor fired the first round of the seven-gun salute. Today, my friends, I want to look at Satan's gun salute, which even though is given at the welcoming of the head of state, Nevertheless, on this occasion, it was deceitful and designed to assassinate the king of creation. The first gun salute resulted in a great mourning. The second resulted in a great faith. The third resulted in a great earthquake. And the fourth resulted in a great commission. This morning, my friends, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, the Bible tells us that wise men came from the east to Jerusalem asking for the king of the Jews, stating that they had seen a star in the east and had come to worship him. Yes. These sentiments reached the ears of Herod the king, and obviously he was shaken with insecurity at the prospect of being dethroned by a Jewish ruler. The Bible describes his emotion as troubled, and his entire country were troubled as well. Amen. Friends, this morning, Herod inquired as to where Christ would be born, and discovered from the chief priests and the scribes that he would be born in Bethlehem of Judea. Yes. Herod, in a jealous rage, demanded and called the wise men and sent them to Bethlehem to search diligently for the child. Yes. And when they would have found him, he told them to let him know that he could come and worship him also. My hearers, this morning, I want to reveal to you today that it is, inasmuch as this seemed to be very innocuous, very, very pure and simple, it is deeper than we can ever imagine. You see, all of this was a part of the devil's strategy. The wise man, however, did go to Jerusalem. They did find the child Jesus, but they were warned of God in a dream not to return, so they departed into another country. Friends, this morning, when Herod heard and saw that he was outwitted, the Bible tells us that he was mocked. He was exceeding angry, and he said, and slew all the children that were in Bethlehem. You know, before today, we always say he slew all the male children. But when we read the Bible carefully, we find that he slew all of the children, that included girls, that were in Bethlehem, and all of them that were in the coast thereof. And so, my friends, the consequence of this first God salute of Satan's honor God was a great mourning. The Bible described this event as follows. Then when Herod saw that he was mocked of the wise men, he was exceeding angry and sent forth and slew all the children that were in Bethlehem and all the coast thereof from 2 years old and older. Then was fulfilled that was spoken by the prophet Jeremy, saying, in Ramah, there was a voice heard, lamentation and great mourning, Rachel weeping for her children and would not be comforted because they are not. Therefore, on this resurrection morning, on this Easter Sunday, as some may call it, I wish to tell you that before Christ is resurrected in you, there must be a great mourning. A great mourning in your soul for the sins you would have committed by commission and omission. There must be a great mourning to let go of the flesh. I want to tell you this morning that Rachel's children are according to the flesh, but thank God Mary's boy child is according to the Spirit. My heirs, this morning, Jesus said, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. The psalmist tells us that weeping may endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. And so, don't despair if you're going through some hard times this morning. Don't despair if you're going through some difficult times. You may have lost a loved one. Satan may have taken your job away from you. Your bills may be so heavy for you to bear, but I came to tell you this morning that he is celebrating the joy that comes in the morning. The second round of Satan's guard of honor. This great, wonderful salute. Many of you will recall that when we talk about a guard of honor, normally if a head of state is coming to a country, or the queen is coming to visit us, they will set up a guard of honor comprising of all either the defense force or a combination of defense force and police officers. And they will have several of those officers that they call, they will have the gun salute. And once the Queen comes, they will fire off a volley, one, two, three, up to seven or more rounds of volley of gun salute to say to the visiting monarch, we are welcoming you. Right. And so this is what Satan did when Jesus came. He set up his God upon her, and he allowed his demons to fire off some salutes. And the second of this, when he fired off the second salute, this was the salute that I call the great faith. Yeah. By now you would recognize that we are talking about four greats that occur as a result of what Satan did to diminish the work of Christ on our behalf. My friends, when Jesus walked through the countryside, he was often met by a huge crowd, and on one occasion, he had entered into Capernaum, where a certain centurion servant was sick.